And this is the classic question which I would have absolutely asked myself, mm-hmm. because there have been so many great players that you've played with. Who is your favourite player ever that you've played with? You can't say your brother.
No, he was also quite good, but favourite player... I think when Rivaldo at that time, you know, or favorite player, one of the best that I ever played with, especially on the left wing. For me, he was amazing, you know, fantastic crosses. He could score goals. He could head, fantastic header. He was for me a fantastic person also, and a fantastic player.
You've played with some great ones. Here's another one that you have played with. This question asks, what was it like playing with Dennis Bergkamp?
Yeah, we had a very good understanding together. You know, everybody remembered the pass that I gave to Dennis in the 98 World Cup against Argentina in the quarterfinals. But, you know, I gave him a lot of this also in the regular competition. And, he is famous of his touch, you know, especially when the ball is in the air. I remember a goal against Vitesse. I think Wim Jong gives the ball to him and he takes the ball in the air. And the second touch was also in the air and chips it over the goalkeeper. Yeah, that was really typical Dennis Bergkamp goal. Yeah, sometimes you think, OK, is this possible? And yeah, that was Dennis. And he also showed it, of course, here in the Premier League with Arsenal.
So that pass that you were talking about, that you made for him, when you played that ball, were you thinking this is a goal-scoring chance?
No, not at all, not at all. Of course, I know that he understands me and I understand him. So when he makes one step inside, he wants the ball more behind the last four.
That's the little signal for you.
Yeah. So I did, and yeah. Then of course I had quite a good pass. That the accuracy is then a little bit better maybe than other players, but still he has to do all the things after that, and he did unbelievable with Ayal. He tripped him, something like that, and he finished fantastic at that moment.
Certainly did. What a goal that was. Now, some of our younger viewers might not remember him, Frank, but we're talking about Marco van Basten. Which current footballer would you...
We talked about Rivaldo, but I only played in 92 the World Cup, the European Cup in Sweden with him. And of course, when I was young, playing for in the Academy of Ajax, we had always free tickets to watch the game. And yeah, Van Basten was one of my favorite players. And I still believe when he didn't get this ankle injury, he was maybe on the same level as Johan Cruyff. So he was an unbelievable player.
I mean, what a player.
I think he won three times
European,
Ballon d'Or.
Yeah, the Ballon d'Or, yeah.
So that means, yeah, he was really... And I remember Capello when he finished career, he had tears in his eyes because he knew that, you know, some special person ended his career.
I think from 88, when Holland won the European Championships, to maybe 92, yeah. I think he was not just the best striker in the world, he could have been the best player.
Yeah, no, 100%, 100%. And because he had everything, he was smart. Good technique, finishing fantastic. No, fantastic player.
This one comes in from Ronald de Boer.
Who was better, you or Ronald?
I always say we cannot compare. My brother always say that he is the better player because he won two times. He was best player of Holland, you know, voted. So that the credits I have to give to him, but you know, I'm the better defender. So maybe character-wise, I was better, that's for sure, character-wise. But when you really look for talent, then maybe he was.
So when
but you know, you cannot be top if you don't have talent, but also when you don't have character.
So when you were young, growing up together, where were your matches being played out? Were they in the house, in the sitting room, in the garden?
No, a lot of times just on the street. And one against one, but also a lot of times, then I was goalkeeper and he was shooting, and or the opposite side. But I was always a left winger when I was young, and he played more in the midfield or sometimes defense. So, and then suddenly when I came to Ajax, we changed that.
I'm interested in this one as well. What advice would you give to coaches about how to develop young players?
Yeah, if you really see that somebody, you know, have really potential, you have to give him time and confidence. And because there are a lot of managers are too afraid, you know, but at the end they will pay you back, that I'm convinced of. I did it with Christian. I had no doubts to put him directly in the team. Of course, I knew him already from the academy, and I said to Danny Blind, the father of Daley Blind, he was assistant of Jol, you have to take him because he is already too good for the academy. He has to play minutes in the first team. You will see he's going to make the difference. And yeah, they can only learn when they play on the highest level. And they will make mistakes, of course. But at the end, they will pay you back.
It's not always possible, though, is it? I mean, you know from experience, you don't get time.
No, no, not at all, especially here, you know. They're all worried about the £100 million they get every year.
Are we?
Yeah, but that's true.
It's the reality, isn't it?
Yeah.
Which makes it very difficult. Yeah. Do you think we'll ever see the likes of that Ajax team that we talked about, a group of young players coming through and being successful at a top club?
No, hopefully, hopefully now. Normally, I always say you have to be like 24, 25 to make the next step. I left to Barcelona when I was almost 29. So that's the big difference. Now they already leave at 21. Yeah, for me, you know, you're still developing. And when you go then to a big team, they expect you to be a player who can really directly start, but that's not the case. And so for me, when you're 25, 26, 24, maybe you have also experience, then you think, hey, I can also help other players. Yeah. And before that, you're only concerned about yourself. You're still developing yourself.